by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
The Apostle Peter testifies to the action of God in Christ to Gentiles, sharing the astonishingly good news of forgiveness and freedom. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter began to speak to Cornelius and the other Gentiles. I truly understand that God shows no partiality, but in every nation, anyone who fears him and does what is right is acceptable to him. You know the message he sent to the people of Israel, preaching peace by Jesus Christ. He is Lord of all. That message spread throughout Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John announced, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power, how he went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses to all that he did, both in Judea and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. But God raised him on the third day and allowed him to appear, not to all the people, but to us, who were chosen by God as witnesses, and who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one ordained by God as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him, that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm I'm going for this morning is Psalm 118, which is on the insert in your bulletins. We will read this psalm responsibly by the whole verse, beginning and ending with the refrain. On this day
the Lord has acted, we will rejoice and be glad in it.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His mercy endures forever.
Let Israel not proclaim, his mercy endures forever.
The Lord is my strength and my song, and he has become my salvation.
There is sound of exultation and victory in the tents of the righteous.
The right hand of the Lord has triumphed. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. The right hand of the Lord has triumphed.
I shall not die but thee, and declare the works of the Lord.
The Lord has punished me sorely, but he did not hand me over to death.
Open for me the gates of righteousness.
This is the gate of the Lord. He who is righteous may enter.
I will give thanks to you, for you have answered me, and have become my salvation.
The same stone which the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone.
This is the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous in our eyes.
On this day the Lord has acted. We will rejoice and be glad in it.
On this day the Lord has acted, we will rejoice and be glad in it.
The Apostle Paul recounts to the Corinthian Christians all of the many witnesses to Jesus' resurrection, reminding them that this event at the center of their faith has truly occurred and has the power to transform. A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. Now I would remind you, brothers and sisters, of the good news that I proclaimed to you, which you in turn received, in which also you stand, through which also you are being saved, if you hold firmly to the message that I proclaimed to you, unless you have come to believe in vain. For I handed on to you as of first importance what I in turn had received, that Christ died for our sins in accordance with the Scriptures, and that he was buried, and that he was raised on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures, and that he appeared to Cephas, then to the 12. Then he appeared to more than 500 brothers and sisters at one time, most of whom are still alive, though some have died. Then he appeared to James, then to all the apostles. Last of all, as to one untimely born, he appeared also to me. For I am the least of the apostles, unfit to be called an apostle, because I persecuted the church of God. But by the grace of God I am what I am, and his grace toward me has not been in vain. On the contrary, I worked harder than any of them, though it was not I, but the grace of God that is with me. Whether then it was I or they, so we proclaim, and so you have come to believe. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Lord Jesus Christ, according to John.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one whom Jesus loved, and said to them, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him." And Peter and the other disciple set out and went toward the tomb. The two were running together, but the other disciple, our friend Peter, reached the tomb first. He bent down to look in and saw the linen wrappings lying there, but did not go in. And Simon Peter came, following him, and went into the tomb. He saw the linen wrappings lying there, and the cloth that had been on Jesus' head, not lying with the linen wrappings, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple who reached the tomb first also went in, and he saw and believed, for as yet they did not understand the scripture, that he must rise from the dead. Then the disciples returned to their homes, but Mary stood weeping outside the tomb. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white, sitting where the body of Jesus had been lying, one at the head and the other at the feet. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Do not hold on to me, because I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and say to them, I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord." And she told them that he had said these things to her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
So that we can fellowship together. I want to thank God this morning because he has given us this chance so that we be here this morning to celebrate this beautiful day, which is Easter Sunday. It's a day that we glorify God for the mighty things that he has done. And so as we come before his throne of mercy this morning, I pray that we may calm our hearts and minds and just be in his presence. Listen to his word, listen to the music, pray, and also just smell the scent of the blessing and the beautiful flowers that God has given us. And therefore this morning, as we meditate on our word, I just want to focus on one area of our scripture reading, which is about the tomb. In our gospel reading this morning, which was from John's gospel, we are told that Mary, early in the morning, she rushed to the tomb when it was still dark. And in the gospel according to Mark, it gives us more details of Mary. It says, on the way with other women, they were discussing how they were going, you know, to the tomb and who will roll the stone away from the tomb. After the burial of Jesus in this new tomb, the stone was rolled and closed. They thought that Jesus' life had come to an end, and as it was a custom, they buried him. But that was not the end. Christ is no longer in the tomb. While these women were traveling or walking early in the morning to go to the tomb, with their minds preoccupied with who will roll away the stone so that they can do the service that they wanted to do, that was not what they were supposed to be.